Hive's modulation matrix comprises two banks of six functionally identical slots each, in which an array of modulation sources can be assigned to just about every one of its visible controls and a number of hidden ones. To open the modulation matrix, click the MM1 or MM2 button. MM1 for slots 1 to 6, MM2 for slots 7 to 12. The modulation slots are all on by default, but they can be turned off individually with their power buttons. Each slot enables a single modulation source to be assigned to one or two targets, with a via modulator in between that modulates the modulation depth. To activate a modulator, click the source menu in a slot and choose it from the list that appears. To assign the source to a target, either right-click one of the same slot's two target fields and choose a destination from the list, or left-click and hold the target field, then drag the crosshairs to the destination. Set the modulation depth with the bipolar knob to the left and assign a separate source to modulate the depth in the via menu. Modulation sources include Hive's LFOs, envelopes, arpeggiator and sequencer, as well as the usual lineup of MIDI signals, velocity, expression, mod wheel, etc., and a trio of special sources, alternate, random and constant. Alternate outputs plus 100 with one note, minus 100 with the next, plus 100 with the one after that, and so on. Random outputs a random value from minus 100 to plus 100 per note. And constant outputs a fixed plus 100 signal for activating hidden parameters and applying controllable offset through adjustment of modulation depth. Modulation targets comprise the vast majority of the visible controls in all of Hive's sections, yes, even effects, and several less obvious and even completely hidden ones. For example, point an LFO, envelope, or other source at the octave or semitone menus for pitch modulation, the phase menu for phase modulation, or the wave menu with pulse selected for pulse width modulation. Then there's the invisible oscillator tune and a couple of delay parameters, which we look at in the oscillators and effects videos. Being hidden, these can only be selected via the target field's right-click menu.